Hey guys, what's up? It's your YouTuber Jaya. Welcome back to my channel. We talk about all things money, finance, and entrepreneurship. Guys, in today's video, we are going to be going over 5 of the best bank accounts of 2021. So recently, well, kind of not recently, about like 6 or 7 months ago, I made a video talking about some of the best bank accounts for beginners and teenagers, and you all seem to really like that video. So this video is kind of like a sister to that video. And so these are going to be the best bank accounts of 2021. These bank accounts aren't necessarily beginner friendly. When I say beginner friendly, I mean like not for like teenagers. These are more geared toward if you're in your early 20s, 20, 21, or in your mid-20s, and you're trying to have bank accounts set up to like help you with life. As you get older, and I don't even mean like super older, like in your 30s or 40s, I mean just like in your early 20s, mid-20s, there are things that you have to start being able to like take care of, such as getting approved for car loans, personal loans, student loans, and having a good relationship with a good bank can help you get lower interest rates for all of the loans that you need to apply for. And there's also a lot of other reasons why you should establish a good relationship with a good bank, but we're gonna get all into that. Before we jump into today's video, please make sure you give this video a thumbs up because it definitely helps out my channel. Make sure you follow me on Instagram and Twitter because I'm active there almost daily. And without further ado, let's jump into today's video. There are a lot of reasons why you should have a good relationship with a bank, and I'm just gonna go over a couple. Number one, like I was saying in the beginning, you get lower interest rates on products such as cars, houses, personal loans, student loans. You're able to get lower interest rates when you have a track record of being financially responsible with your bank. Number two is you're able to negotiate loans and interest rates. Say for example, you want to purchase your first car and the bank tells you, okay, we'll let you purchase a car from us and we'll give you a 5% interest rate and your budget is $50,000. But you want a little bit more money and a lower interest rate. So if you have a good relationship with the bank, you can be like, you know what? I want a 4.5 interest rate and $55,000. And if the bank trusts you, they may say, you know what? Deal. Number three, lower fees. When you have a good relationship with the bank, let's say you accidentally overdraft your account, and this is not something you do very often because you have a good relationship with the bank, you just call the bank and be like, hey, such and such, I accidentally overdraft my account, can you help me out? And they're like, I got you. And they reverse the overdraft and all the other fees that you can possibly get with if you didn't have a better relationship with the bank or something. I don't know. And last but not least, my last reason, number four, is when you have a better relationship with the bank, they treat you like you're a higher tier client. Higher tier clients get better, more customer service. And I know that doesn't sound like a big deal, but customer service can make or break your banking experience. Bad customer service will literally make you want to close the whole account and get a whole new bank account, especially going back to number three, when we're talking about having fees waived and overdrafts and stuff like that, calling up the bank, asking if they can do anything about it. Bad customer service will literally make you want to close your whole account. Coming in at number one, we have Alliant Credit Union. Establishing a good relationship with a credit union can really help you out with your finances in the future. Credit unions typically offer lower interest rates and higher interest rates on savings accounts. So say for example, you want to buy a car. A lot of times when people buy cars, they don't get their financing from the car dealership. They'll go to the credit lender or they'll go to the bank to see if they can offer them a cheaper interest rate than what the car dealership is giving them. So you may want to buy a Ford and the Ford car dealership is giving you a 5.5 interest rate. You go to your credit union and they may give you a 4.5 interest rate because you have a good relationship with them already. Secondly, credit unions typically offer a higher interest rate on savings accounts. Your typical bank account such as Chase, Bank of America, Wells Fargo, their savings accounts attachments only offer an interest rate of about 0.0%. Alliant Credit Union's savings account has an interest rate of 0.78%, and their checking account also has an interest rate of 0.25%. They also offer kids' savings accounts, and going back to my good bank account checklist, we love a good checklist over here, y'all. No monthly fees, no minimum balance, no limitations on the number of transactions. It says on their website that they have ATMs everywhere. They have online access. You can get on online. I did not check if they have an app, but if they do, it will be on the screen. And of course, they have a savings account attachment. Coming in at number two, we have the Discover checking accounts, you guys. When we talk about graduating from our teen checking accounts that don't really offer any rewards, they don't really have any benefits, we should graduate to the Discover It online checking account. The Discover It online checking account offers 1% cash back on all purchases. That's like a credit card thing, you know? And this is a bank account that's offering you 1% cash back on all purchases. That's very unique. That's very nice. So it offers 1% cash back every single month up to $3,000, and their savings account attachment has a 40% annual percentage yield. So when we're talking about stepping stones, graduating from our teen checking account, this is a great stepping block. Coming in at number three, we have the so fancy, so eloquent, so elegant. We have Charles Schwab. Let me be correct here. Let me make sure I'm being correct. We have the Schwab Bank High Yield Investor checking account. Very, very fancy. Now, I used to think this is a very fancy, very elite bank account. And by fancy and elite, I mean they don't require you to have $15,000 in the bank or else they'll charge you $40 a month. But after doing a little bit of research, I find that this is a great bank account for people who want to get into investing into the stock market. It is never too early to get into investing into the stock market. In fact, the way the stock market and investing is set up is that time is on your side. So the more time you have, the better it's going to work out for you. There are no monthly service fees, so you have more money to invest. Along with having no fees, there are also no minimum balances, which came as a shock to me because just looking at it initially, I thought you would have had to have $5,000 or $10,000 to bank with them, but you do not have to have a minimum balance in this account in order to bank with them. They have unlimited ATM fee rebates. Now, I just want to explain what a fee rebate is. So from my understanding is sometimes, you know, you'll go to the ATM and they'll be like, hey, it charged you $350 to use this ATM, but a fee rebate means that they will refund you that money. So what they'll do is they'll take all the fees you had to pay for the ATM for the month and they'll reimburse you at the end of the month when you get your bank statement. They also have a really good mobile banking app. So it seems to me that overall, this is a really good checking account for somebody who wants to get into investing into the stock market and also saving for retirement. Coming in at number four, we have Chase Total checking accounts. Now, so I have the Chase Total College checking account, and I have one Chase Total checking account, and it's the Chase Total checking account could be an amazing bank account if I would just switch over my direct deposit to that bank account, but I haven't. So every single month it charges me $12 because I don't have a minimum of $1,500 in that account. But the Chase College checking account, we're doing great, okay? It's a great bank. I have had this bank account since 2019. I actually opened it around June in 2019. This is June in 2021. So I've had this bank account for about 2 years now. And so far I have opened 4 other Chase College checking accounts because that's just how much I love Chase Bank. They are a great bank to bank with. Their customer service is amazing. Their app is seamless. As far as this little $12 fee, that's literally the only fee that I've ever had to pay since I've been banking with them. I've never overdraft my account, but I do know if you do overdraft your account, they do charge you like a $35 fee, which is very steep, but just try your best not to overdraft your account. It just came to my memory. I did have another bank account with them. I had a business bank account with them, but you had to have a minimum balance in that account, and I wasn't really using the account like that. However, it was charging me $15 every single month, even though I wasn't using it. So I called Chase and I asked them to refund it And they did. They refunded like 2 months worth or 3 months worth of $15 because I just had the account open and it was just taking money out the account and it was about to overdraft the account. So I called them and they refunded it for me, and that was amazing because I really did not have to do that. The college checking account you can open up as early as 17. And as far as them charging you a fee, they don't charge you a fee if you have a direct deposit going into that account. And lastly, but certainly not least, coming in at number 5, we have Ally Bank. Ally Bank is great for a lot of reasons. First of all, their checking account is an interest earning checking account and it earns interest at about... Their checking account is an interest earning checking account that earns 0.10 annual percentage yield if you have less than $15,000 in your account every single year. If you have more than $15,000 in your account, it earns 0.25 annual percentage yield. Every single year. There's no monthly fees, there's no minimum balance, it's FDIC insured, but for Ally Bank, I really want to talk about their savings accounts. One thing that definitely stood out to me about Ally's savings accounts is that they have a feature where you can divide up different things that you want to save your money for. So for example, let's say you want to save for a vacation, but you also want to save for a new pair of shoes, and you also want to save for a new hairstyle that you really want that's kind of expensive. Instead of just saying I need $2,000 in my savings account, you can set $900 for vacation, $200 for shoes, $400 for hair, and you can all have it divided up into different savings accounts so you can specifically put money towards different things. The next thing that their savings account does is roundups. So if you have an Ally Bank checking account, and let's say you go to Starbucks, yes, and you spend $4.85, they will round up that extra 15 cents. And then once you hit $5, they will transfer $5 into your savings account. And last but not least, their savings account has an annual percentage yield of 0.50%. So all in all, this is a great checking account and a great savings account attachment combo. They complement each other very well, if you ask me. So Ally Bank is a really good bank account and checking account. Thank you so much for sticking with me throughout this whole video. I really hope I was able to deliver a lot of good information to you all about getting a bank account, establishing a good relationship with the bank, some really good bank accounts and what their qualities are and what they offer. And I just really hope I was able to deliver a great video to you guys. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up because it definitely helps out my channel. Make sure you comment down below. Comment down below, out of all the bank accounts that I mentioned, out of all 5, which one are you thinking about opening up? And last but not least, of course, make sure you subscribe, okay? Because we're talking about checking accounts over here. We're establishing good relationships with banks over here. So make sure you subscribe. Why wouldn't you want to subscribe to that? I don't know, but I would. Okay, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and in the meantime, stay strong. Bye guys.